Welcome to the world of group home riches, where you can achieve financial freedom while making a positive impact on society. Are you tired of working long hours for someone else? Do you dream of being your own boss and creating a better future for yourself and others? Look no further. With Group Home Riches, you can invest in real estate and provide a valuable service by offering safe and comfortable homes for individuals in need.
The number one investment in real estate.
And start building a better future for yourself and those around you. Let's make a difference together with Group Home Riches.
So I actually stumbled upon another group initially that were kind of doing the shared housing model. They were really geared towards recovery homes for the addiction community. And I kind of went through their stuff, but they were more geared towards like nonprofits. And it was just too much red tape for me. I really wanted just like a straight business. And so I was talking to a friend of mine who was also just interested in taking the real estate and the co-living strategy and helping people and putting that all together. So I was just trying to figure it out. And I was talking to a friend of mine and she recommended you guys. And so I just kind of jumped into the podcast, saw the gold course for $200. And I was like, oh, like this is the cheapest thing I've ever seen in the real estate education industry, and jumped on it. And then I was pretty blown away by like, I mean, it's basically like a franchise in a box. Like you have the whole business model there, and it just made, it just connected a lot of dots. It made perfect sense to me.
Explain for the other folks that might be on that similar journey. You know, they're looking up how to start assisted living facilities. Maybe they're looking into nonprofits and things like that. What was it about kind of our messaging and stories and stuff like that that stuck out as different to all those other strategies?
Well, I think with y'all, it's just, I mean, it's a lower barrier to entry for somebody who's trying to get started. Because if you're looking to go the licensed route, that takes a lot of really, really specialized knowledge. It takes a lot of capital that most regular people just don't really have starting out. So first of all, I didn't even know you could do this like unlicensed, right? So I thought that was really cool. And then in terms of just how you go through the marketing and reaching out to the different agencies so that you can get the rents covered by third parties, I just thought was brilliant. Like you're just outsourcing the more intensive portion, but still providing a very valuable housing service to people that would otherwise fall through the cracks.
Let's rewind a little bit, because as you know, when you're looking into this stuff, there is a lot of information out there that typically just kind of takes you down the path in some sort of way. It's licensing or certifications of some sort, right?
Mm-hmm. So yes.
Why don't you break down for the folks? Do we just show you how to like avoid and duck the authorities, or what's different? You said you don't have to get a license. I'm sure there's a lot of people that just heard that and were like, wait, what? So why don't you break that down a little bit?
Yeah, it took me a minute to get comfortable with it too.
Exactly.
I mean, luckily through the content in the gold course, it really breaks it down like the exact laws and the reason why you're protected, because this falls under federal fair housing law. And so when you really break it down and you think about it like, okay, this is no different than student housing, where if you have a single family home and you're renting each room to a student, that's allowed. So, okay. Then if you have somebody who is struggling with addiction, who's considered mentally disabled under federal fair housing law, you can't discriminate against them because they're a protected class.
That's a perfect example. So what would it be called if, remind the folks out there where you are in Louisiana, correct?
Yes, I'm in Lafayette, Louisiana.
So there's college housing or like young professionals that live together out there, right?
Absolutely. Yep.
Those landlords don't need a certificate or license, right?
They do not.
So if you were to house, say, people 65 and up, same living situation, the people just happen to be older, and the city comes by and says, whoa, 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 Hannah, you need a license and you need to fill out this paperwork and you need to pay us $350 in order to house these type of people. What would that be called?
Discrimination.
Bingo. Bingo. And we'll get into like the demographics that you serve and your property and everything like that. We'll just keep it vague for now. Let's say some of the people living in your properties now, they do need like, say, medical service, even counseling, right? Like addiction counseling. Do you need to go out and find employees to do that? Or how is that handled?
I do not. So, and they pretty much understand the scenario that this is housing only. And we make that very clear. It's also very clear in the licensing agreement. I do have a house manager who has like a counseling type background, but he is not counseling them individually or anything of that nature. I have compiled just a list of organizations that can kind of help, and I'll point them in that direction, but that's up to them.
How often do you even need to do that?
Not very often. They actually come in pretty familiar with the system, so they kind of know what to do and where the resources are.
Want to learn more about the future real estate? Sign up for your free training material at www.grouphomeriches.com.